Holcomb is sitting down to talk about the highs and lows of 2019.
He's focused on the year ahead while also in the middle of an election.
Fox 59's Kayla Sullivan sat down with the governor this afternoon to talk about the state's focus on education and the year ahead and the year we just went through.
That is true. Well, education is quickly becoming the most important topic of conversation as we move into the new year. We've heard from teachers about their demands for 2020, but Holcomb stands by his decision to wait until next year to give them more money. We asked if the governor feels this may impact his reelection.
I don't fear, no. We're going to do the right thing.
The Indiana State Teachers Association wants $75 million to go toward teacher pay next year, but Governor Eric Holcomb says he wants to find a systemic fix first.
That Teacher Compensation Commission, of which the Teachers Association sits on at the table, they're going through and they're going to be able to, with us and us with them, identify what is that gap? How do we reach that goal?
Holcomb wants Indiana to be top three in the Midwest for teacher pay. He says waiting until next budget year in 2021 will help the state get there.
We need to fix this systemically in a sustainable way. You do that with your budget.
He credits the $763 million the state allocated toward education as a top accomplishment in 2019. He also notes eliminating the tax on military pensions, passing a hate crimes law, and making progress on the state's workforce development programs.
The amount of investment we're making in our infrastructure, in our roads, in our rail, in our broadband internet, affordable service.
When asked about the downside of 2019, Holcomb pointed to those we lost.
Birch Bayh and Dick Lugar, and we lost a trooper not too long ago. And those are gut-wrenching, hard to deal with.
Holcomb says those people helped get Indiana to where it's headed in 2020.
We were a state that was moving forward and making progress before I was sworn in. And all we've done is take it to the next level. We've just built on records that were set before me and broke those.
Well, earlier this week, we outlined Holcomb's agenda for next year. It includes a law banning handheld electronic devices while driving, transparency in health care prices, and raising the age to buy tobacco to 21. If you'd like to see a full list and more on my interview from today, head to our website, fox59.com.
Kayla, thanks. We'll also have much more of that interview with Governor Holcomb and a preview of the upcoming legislative session on this week's edition of In Focus. It airs Sunday morning at 9:30 right here on Fox 59. Well, this is pretty cool. Governor Holcomb is now the proud owner of a very unique collection. He's got them all. A signature from our very first president, George Washington. He showed this to Kayla today. Completing the governor's collection of signatures from every single U.S. president. In the past, we've shown you Governor Holcomb's collection before. He had almost all of them. We took you inside his mansion back in February. He started this collection 2 decades ago. Now, he has all the presidents.
They were quite eloquent back in the day and dealt with some very heady issues. You know, some deal with things more calmly, some add humor, some are a little bit more erratic, and it comes out in their words.
Quite a look back at the presidency there in that collection. The envelope with President Washington's signature dates back to 1780. President George Washington at the time was writing to a deputy at Fort Pitt. Governor Holcomb says it took him a few years to save up to buy this final piece of his collection.
There's a new way to honor our Hoosier heroes in the circle.